Did you know that a lot of us already use assistive technology in our everyday lives? An example of that would be the mainstream prescribed glasses to correct short-sightedness. So today we are at TechAble at the Enabling Village to see how people with disabilities can live more independently thanks to AT. So this right here is the CPEN. It is a reader pen that can scan and read text out loud to a user. Wow. It basically uses painted camera technology as well as a very special software to make sure that it can capture and process text to a high accuracy. So something like this would be really useful for people with visual impairments or even dyslexia. And something really cool about it, it also has a dictionary function, voice memo, and it can work as a USB stick too. And here we have LiftWhereLevel. For stroke survivors or people without a huge range of motion in their upper limbs, they may face some difficulty feeding themselves because they can't balance their cutlery properly. So what LiftWhereLevel does is that it holds the end of the cutlery upright should the user end up tilting the spoon or the fork backwards because they can't balance it or hold it upright properly. This comes with a spoon and fork attachment, and it basically enables users to feed themselves soups or semi-solid foods, which they wouldn't be able to do so with traditional cutlery. Another version of the self-leveling spoon would be the Ellie spoon right here, but this one is not battery operated. It basically relies on the counterweights on either side of the spoon to balance it out. It's pretty smooth. This is the Uccello Kettle. So for people with weak limbs or maybe even arthritis, pouring hot water out of a kettle can be potentially dangerous. While the Uccello Kettle right here is super snazzy because all you have to do is use one finger to tilt it at an angle, and it pours out directly into your cup. So this works because it sits on a tilting base. And with this universal design, anyone, including children, can use this kettle safely at home. Now, if you don't have something like this, you can also get this rack right here that can hold any kettle, and it just functions more manually. And you can do the same thing. Easy. This is Naktafie. Now, we don't really think about doorbells, do we? When we have a visitor at home, they ring our doorbell, we hear it, so we answer the door. But for people with hearing impairment, they would need another form of cue to notify them that they have a visitor. So Naktafie presents the solution for that. This is a device that you can place at any area in your home, and when someone rings your doorbell, it flashes or vibrates to let you know that there's someone at your door. And on top of that, you can even customize the color of the notification. For example, I can program it to red for the main door or green for the kitchen door. And finally, there is what we call VR modules. These are delivered through mainstream devices such as the Samsung Gear VR. Now, VR modules basically present a safe and controlled environment for people to experience new objects or situations. And customized content can be designed for people with different needs. For example, people with autism tend to be sensitive towards external stimuli like light and noise. So in this case, customized content can be designed for them to acclimatize themselves to situations such as visiting the dentist. Technology brings convenience to us all. But for persons with disability, assistive technology can be transformative, allowing them to live more independently. Now, if you want to check out more of these assistive technology devices, you can do so right here at TechAble at the Enabling Village.